Hello and welcome back to Module 2. This is the second part of Module 2 where we're going to be concentrating on searching the internet. And in particular, what we're going to be looking at here is we're going to be looking at different types of search engine. I think it's really, really important that when we think about search engines and we're using search engines with our students, we don't just rely on the old favourites such as Google. Before we start, I think that searching the internet is one of the most difficult things that we do these days, and one of the reasons for that is because there's so much information on the internet. Being able to search efficiently is something that we must teach our young people across Europe if they are going to be efficient and productive in the 21st century. The other thing to mention is, of course, search is massive and a very, very popular thing to do. If we look at just Google, for example, 40,000 search queries a second, 3.5 billion searches per day, and that's 1.2 trillion searches a year. Search is big, and it's certainly also big business. There's lots and lots of different search engines out there, and everybody's got their favourite. The challenge with students is getting them to experiment with different types of search engine so they can start to understand that different search engines work in different ways. Here are a few types of search engines to think about. It's up to you to think about what's the best one to use depending on what it is you're wanting to do. Google is, of course, the most popular search engine in the world, and it's definitely a really, really good search engine. But there are other search engines that you should also consider as well. I don't know if you've heard of Baidu, but Baidu is actually the second most popular search engine in the world. It's really popular in China. Bing is Microsoft's equivalent of a search engine. Again, it offers search features such as maps and video and image search. You've probably also heard of Yahoo search. Other search engines include ask.com, or in the UK it's called askjeeves.com. This type of search engine specialises in answering questions rather than just search terms. Then we've got websites like DuckDuckGo. DuckDuckGo his main mission is to ensure your privacy. It doesn't track what you're searching for online, unlike some of the other big search giants. Then we've got websites like Dogpile. Dogpile's a really interesting search engine to try with your students because it uses metadata to take the best results from a number of other search engines across the web, including Google, Yahoo, and Ask. Instagrok is one of the little hidden gems, which I'm going to talk about later on in the unit. What Instagrok does is it's a visual search, and it pulls together different ways that search engines are connected to different types of content across the web. Really, really good for project work if you've not seen it. Quora is about answering questions, but the questions are answered by people that really know about what they're talking about because they have to submit their credentials beforehand. Then, a bit like Wikipedia, the answers are refined until you actually get a really, really accurate answer. It's quite a good place for going for some research, particularly for older students. For older students as well, they probably want to look at particularly academic websites or academic search engines. For example, the Library of Congress or Google Scholar, which will search for academic journals. The Wayback Machine is another one of my favourites. The Wayback Machine allows you to search websites that no longer exist because it's copied them and archived them in the past. It's a great historical source of information for recent history, but it's also a fascinating way to be able to look back at what's previously been deleted from the internet, or not deleted, you might say. Technorati is a specialist blog search, really, really useful for getting a personal opinion on something. Then, of course, we've got other specialist websites. Recipe Bridge specialises in searching for recipes on the web. Kelco is a shopping website looking for different price comparisons. And then we've got travel websites like Kayak or Skyscanner that will search to get the best deal on things like flights or hotel rooms. Zoopla is really, really popular for searching for property. There really are lots and lots of different types of web search engines these days. Spookido searches for people. It's actually quite a scary engine to look at. And if you think Spookido's scary, then you might want to try Shadan. Shadan actually looks and searches for online devices that basically you can access and potentially hack into. So as I say, there really is these days a search engine for everything. If you want to find out about lots of different types of search engine and explore the ones that you perhaps haven't heard of, I recommend the list of search engines on Wikipedia. Of course, Wikipedia is not a bad search engine in itself as well, but we'll come back to that in later modules. Another really, really good resource to look at is Search Engine Land. This talks all about the advantages and disadvantages of different search engines, and also gives you an idea about how different search engines adapt their metadata and algorithms to help you find content. If you're interested in this sort of thing, I'd definitely recommend having a look at Search Engine Land. So, here's something for you to think about and something for you to do. What's your favourite search engine and why? And can you recommend any other good search engines, other than the ones I've mentioned, to the other course participants? Perhaps you could post your answer on Facebook, on Twitter, or in the online forums. Remember, there's lots of other people participating in this course who will be able to support you. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.